We are in Lalbagh in the heart of old Bengaluru, and we are here at an establishment that's not just another eatery but a culinary institution in Nama Bengaluru. We are here at Mavalli Tiffin Rooms, or more popularly known as MTR. The story of MTR goes back over 90 years ago when two brothers, Yagna Narayan and Parmeshwar Maiya, came from Kota, a small hamlet in South Canara, to Bangalore in search of livelihoods as cook. Over a period of time, they evolved what came to be known as the Brahmanara Coffee Club, which then evolved into Mavalli Tiffin Rooms as it stands here. This building came up in 1959, and the restaurant has held on to its culinary traditions since then. So let's go in and take a look at what makes MTR or Mavalli Tiffin Rooms really special. All these photographs that have probably been, all these pictures of all these great personalities who've dined here years and years ago. You get an incredible sense of history when you walk into MTR. So these are all the tiffin dishes on offer at MTR. The rava idli, I think, was invented here. Then you've got the vadas, you've got the kesari bath, the bisi bele bath, the masala dosa, the rava masala dosa. They even have a ragi dosa now, and of course the Mangalore buns. So this is what's available during tiffins, but we are here for the MTR thali, the MTR uta, for lunch. I'm here to lunch with Hema Malini Maiya, third generation owner and managing partner, to find out what really makes Mavalli Tiffin Rooms tick. It's just after 1 year in MTR, and I can already hear the sound of happy diners up there who are right now in the middle of lunch, and I think this is what's on the menu today.
Yes.
So you've got a lunch menu here that goes right from juice, kasambri, curry, sagu, chutney. I'm also glad that you got the masala dosa here. It's been ages since I've tasted a MTR masala dosa.
So we serve masala dosa for lunch.
Yeah. Alright. Yeah. But that wasn't the case earlier.
No.
And so do you have a menu that changes every day?
Or? The basic structure remains the same.
Okay.
So there will be different vegetable used for the kosambri and the veg palya. The sambar will have a different vegetable. The sweet would be different. So, you know, the structure remains the same.
So that's what, about roughly about 15-20 dishes each time?
Yes.
All right. Hema's going to invite us back to the kitchen to give us a sneak peek into what really happens for all that food to make its way to your table at MTR. So you got the hot puris that are going up. So is puri something that was always there as part of the MTR tradition?
Yeah.
Okay.
As long as I can remember, it's always been a part of MTR. It was evening tiffin. It started only after 5 p.m. before.
Okay.
Now we serve for lunch.
Popular demand.
Yeah. It's very popular.
Everybody talks about open kitchens and show kitchens, but the walk-in kitchen has been a part of MTR
since
for decades.
Since time,
right?
So the walk-in kitchen was his idea because he felt that first of all, people had to see how we cook,
yes.
You know, how clean it is. You know, to build that confidence too. I'm thinking that when people come, they see it's like a home kitchen, cooked with the best ingredients, and you have the smells wafting, and you know.
Already smell all the aroma, the hot puri frying, and you also have a dosa counter back there. Should we go and take a look?
Yes.
So in MTR, hygiene is an integral part. So no footwear in the main cooking area. Yeah. When do the kitchens here start operations every morning?
Very early in the morning, at around 3:30 is when the first cook comes in.
Wow, 5 o'clock or 5:30, you have your first guest already waiting outside. What time do you open?
Sometimes, I mean, you know, they go for a walk and then they come from the rear entrance, they come in, take their seats. They all have, the old customers have their chairs.
Favorite seats.
Designated chairs, you know. So they sit and wait till serving begins, and especially the coffee, you know. So that's at 6:30.
So I can see some jamuns going. So this is the dessert for today.
Yes, this is the sweet for today.
So I can see all this ghee here. Thuppa.
Yeah, this is another MTR thingy, because we put that dollop of thuppa on everything. I mean, if you have a plate of rava idli, there'll be a dollop of thuppa. On the dosa, in spite of so much ghee going in, we put a batlu, thuppat batlu.
No, so to me, an MTR dosa without this on top is not an MTR dosa. So we are here now at the Masal Dosa room.
Yes.
Where all the Masal Dosa at MTR gets made.
So these are mini dosas.
These are mini dosas.
Yeah.
Made for lunch.
Made for lunch.
What makes the MTR Masal Dosa so popular, so special?
We have our recipe and we make it a certain way. And also the ghee that we use, the ingredients. So I think that is what makes our dosa special.
I love the way dosas are roasting. It's got this nice golden brown sort of a color.
It has to caramelize.
So that's the MTR dosa. So it's kind of crunchy on the top
and soft inside. So that's the milk boiling for the coffee.
So the milk had to yield a certain amount of Goa. What was that?
Yes. That was, I think, around 160 to 180 grams, I think.
So every liter of milk here at MTR has to yield 160 to 180 grams of Goa for the milk to actually find its way into use in the MTR kitchen and into that spectacular MTR coffee that no meal at MTR, for me at least, complete without, and I'm sure also for many of your customers who come
here. Absolutely.
Hema was just showing me the potato and onion storeroom. And I'm told that all these sacks and sacks of potatoes and onions will get over in the next couple of days. So we're finally getting closer to lunch here at MTR. We're finding our way to our table. We're in one of the many rooms here.
Family hall.
Room, and of course, this is a family hall.
It was always called the family hall.
Where traditionally sit.
Yes.
And each time I come here, I will always find waiting. That's quite a feat for an establishment that's been around for over 90 years.
So there are generations of customers coming. Probably a large percentage of people who come in, it's a trip down memories lane, and you know, it's nostalgic for them, and you know, so they come for the experience of it. Mostly it's because we haven't changed anything in the system. The food is cooked the same way.
So when you come to MTR, it's not just, you're not coming here just for the masala dosa, you're not coming here just for the lunch, but you're also coming here for that sense of nostalgia, for that sense of connect to the good old days. Cutlery is here, and the anticipation of this meal has begun.
This is the grapefruit.
And this is an MTR tradition. I don't think any meal at MTR, for me at least, has started without the grape juice. I'm going to have a sip of that. Thank you very much for having us here. Thank you. So there's some kosambri that's gone in, some palya. So we've got, so the thali is slowly but steadily getting filled up. This is a sagu.
Sabha ki kadle bile paisa. Begin with the dosa.
The mini masal dosa. Open a kai.
Gulab jamun.
And of course, there we have the hot puri. So you always start with the dosa and a bit of the palya. You know, it's got that, you have all the flavor of the potatoes and you have that tart.
Yeah, the tartness.
The tartness.
From the batter.
So the tartness is from
the batter. It's from the batter. It's fully, properly fermented batter.
Fully, properly fermented. And that's, you know, I taste this and it takes me right back to the time that I last tasted a masala dosa. So what's interesting is that when you taste the dosa and the chutney, you get all that flavor, you get a bit of the spice, but you also get that slightly grainy bite.
The graininess of the chutney is because of the coconut. And we add a little fried gram that we call.
But what I like is that the masala in this is spread almost all over the dosa. So every bite of the dosa that you take, you've got a bit of the potatoes that comes in. And I think that's the best part of a masala dosa. So I've got some puri and I've dipped it into some of the sagu, the potato. There's a bit of sweetness that's there.
Yeah,
it has that tangy aspect to it. There's a bit of sweet. Yeah. So that's coming from the sagu or is that from the puri?
From the sagu. From the sagu. So you have to dip it in the sagu and the chutney together and eat it actually.
Well, that's a new taste for me. You've got the puri, you've got the potato, and you've got the chutney.
Yeah.
So you got a bit of a dance of flavors that's happening in your mouth. It also gives that chutney a bit of bite.
It gives it bite.
Yeah, so good. This is a famous Bisi Bele Bhat with raita.
Yes.
Okay. It certainly looks bright and you know this is going to be a flavorful Bisi Bele Bhat.
Yes.
You know, I love the bite of the vegetables.
Yeah.
Right? I mean, I would have expected the vegetables to be boiled to a mush.
Yes.
But that's not the case. You still can taste the crunch or the texture of the vegetable. So what's the secret to a good Bisi Bele Bhat? Is it the masala? Is it the spice?
It's the masala too.
Okay.
We have our unique Bisi Bele Bhat masala.
It's literally what it means, you know, Bisi Bele.
So,
you know, there's
hot lentil rice.
Yeah, so there's a lot of dal and very less masala.
And I can also see there's some button onions.
Yeah, onions, those are fried and then added to the rice.
To the rice.
Yes.
Lovely. It also goes very well with the raita.
Raita, yeah.
Bale, kai, palya, raw banana. There's also coconut. There's a tasty fiber, right?
Yes.
That's what raw banana is all about.
Yes.
And this is the...
This is the rave vade.
The rave vade.
Yes. So
this is made with semolina.
Semolina, yeah. Every day. Yeah.
Kara pongal,
yeah. So this is usually made on a Thursday. So there's an extra rice item with a tamarind, jaggery, mildly spiced chutney. We call it hunse no gochu.
Hunse no tamarind,
of
course.
Yeah.
So this is typical to MTR. Is it? Because I haven't tasted this.
It's not typical to MTR. In Karnataka, especially, homes that will give you that tamarind chutney.
Yes. So you've got the dal, you've got the rice.
Yeah.
You've got the ginger, which kind of breaks the flavor. And then you've got the sweet and sour flavor of the tamarind chutney. MTR is a rice eater's paradise.
Absolutely.
Kara pongal is that you've got the peppercorns.
Yeah.
And suddenly in the middle of tasting the rice and the dal, you know, your palate comes alive when you bite into that peppercorn.
Yeah. And we put whole peppercorns in.
That's right.
Yeah.
It's whole peppercorn. So you can definitely feel that peppery heat on your tongue. So do we eat the sabaki paisa in between?
Yeah, you can have sabaki paisa at any point of time. So usually how things are served is in a typical, say a yede utra, you know, South Indian meal, even in MTR, where we used to serve a 40-50 course dinner, it would always be a conscious way of serving things. There will be a sweet, and after that there will be a kara. There will be a sweet,
and then,
there's a savory.
You know what I also appreciate is that it's not overly sweet.
Yeah, it's not overly sweet.
The sweetness is just right.
Yeah.
And I think the kadle bele or the chana that you have boiled is also in the dessert.
Kind of a,
I think it also breaks that sweetness.
It breaks the sweetness you know, sabaki paisa is basically very glutinous and, you know, so it breaks that too.
It also gives it a bit of texture.
Yeah, it gives texture.
Lovely.
Yeah.
Delicious. I think also what the sweet does when you're having it in between all these other dishes is that it It refreshes your palate.
Exactly.
And then you can go back to whatever's coming next.
Yes.
Right, crisp.
Yeah.
And hardly any oil. That is
hardly
still
any
remaining
oil
on the
appala. Hardly any oil.
Appala or the papad. The mini version of it.
Yeah.
More rice coming in. You have to have some tuppa.
Tuppa, yes. Lots of tuppa on everything. This is bendekai huli.
Oh, bendekai huli. So there you go. I have my rice and sambar. But what is traditionally known here as huli with some bendekaya or lady's finger or okra. So my first, second, third serving of something which is rice based, but it's so tasty. So when you're biting into the rice and the bendekaya,
yeah,
you can still get that crunch of the bendekaya.
Yeah.
You know, when you eat at MTR, it's like eating at somebody's home. You know, that's the feeling that I always get.
Yeah.
I've eaten three rice dishes so far. I've had the sabaki paisa, I've had the puri and the sagu, I've had the masal dosa. I've had a bit of the vegetables, but you don't really feel
that bloated
sensation. I mean, you still feel very good about it. It's largely because of the care you know, that your people take, that your cooks take when they prepare the food.
Yeah.
Right from the point that you source the ingredient. More rice. So I've got more rice here and I'm making a nice well to receive the rasam. Thank you. So this is traditionally called the saru here in MTR. That's what the cooks would call it.
Yes.
Let's taste the rasam. So the rice is hot and the rasam is hotter. Or the saru as they call it here in MTR. You know, again, you can taste the spice, but it's, you know, it's all very well balanced out. That's what I really appreciate about the food here at MTR. It's definitely not like eating at a restaurant.
True.
Would you also have some pepper in this?
No pepper.
No pepper in the rasam here. That heat would come from a little bit of red chilli.
Yes.
It's quite a gentle sort of a rasam.
Yeah.
And I'm just loving this with the appala.
Yeah.
Makes for a great combination. And if you want things a little spicy, so a little bit of the uppin kai with the anna saru or the rasam and rice. In all the dishes that came in, I completely forgot the kosambri, and so I'm having it at the end, although you're supposed to have it at the beginning. It's nice, crunchy, fresh. So the last rice course.
This is the typical curd rice. So we don't serve rice and curds. We serve curd rice.
I think at the end of this meal, all that you need is a bit of curd.
This is the last of it.
Fruit salad with a very special ice cream. And you got that cherry on top.
When grand uncle started making ice cream, he just decided to call it American ice cream.
Oh, okay.
You know, and the fruit mixture is called the French fruit mixture.
Oh, okay. So you got American ice cream, French fruit mixture. Mm. And this is made fresh.
It's made fresh, yeah. So we make it centrally now.
Okay.
Oh, and send it to all the restaurants.
So I love this. I love that light creaminess of the American ice cream, as they call it, and the refreshing crunch of all the fruits that have gone into the fruit mix here. Mm. And not to forget the glazed cherry on top. Mm. I've forgotten another dessert that came right at the beginning, which is this plum gulab jamun. So firstly, it's light.
Yes.
It's not too sweet, and there's also a bit of camphor in this.
Yes.
And the customary beeda or paan. The beeda at the end of the meal. Mmm. That was a deliciously satisfying lunch here at MTR. And I want to thank you, Hema, for spending time with us for walking us through the many traditions that makes Mavalli Tiffin Room special, and for sitting with us through lunch and explaining and telling us about what goes into each one of these beautiful dishes that we've tasted here.
It was my pleasure to be on the show.
Thank you very much. And Mavalli Tiffin Room has a nearly 100-year tradition. So I'm sure most of you watching the show out there must have visited MTR at some point in time. But if you haven't, by some chance, you must find your way to Bengaluru and visit Mavalli Tiffin Room here at Lalbagh to soak up a slice of Namma Bengaluru's glorious culinary heritage. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to share and leave a comment. Do subscribe and stay tuned to Food Lovers TV for more episodes from Gourmet on the Road. Happy eating!